In today's video, I will be picking out my top fragrance from 10 different fragrance brands. So if you want to find out more, then please keep on watching. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if it's the first time you are visiting. Thank you so much for joining me today. As already mentioned in the intro, today's video is going to be all about my favorite fragrance from 10 different fragrance brands. Now, this is likely only going to be part one because I have so many brands in my collection, but I've picked out 10 different brands for today's video, and I will be showcasing my personal favorite fragrance from each brand. So without further ado, let's get started on the first fragrance. First up, let's start with Tom Ford. Now, I actually don't have that many fragrances from Tom Ford in my collection, but the ones I do have, I absolutely love. And that one is Noir de Noir. And this is also one of my favorite rose oud fragrances within my collection too. Now, the reason why I've picked Noir de Noir is I feel like this is such a beautiful composition. It's got that traditional rose oud combo, but there are some unique twists in here too. I love that this has a truffle note, and that truffle note I perceive to be almost a little bit oily, and it really stands out and blends beautifully with the rose. I also perceive there to be almost like a dark chocolate note in here as well. There's some patchouli, there's some vanilla, and all in all, I would say this is a very dark and mysterious, sexy fragrance. That's at least how it feels to me whenever I wear it. And when I think about the Tom Ford collection, this one is one of the most wearable for me. So yeah, I absolutely love Noir de Noir, and I highly recommend it for anyone that really does love a rose and oud composition. Now, Tom Ford fragrances are pricey and some of them don't have a great longevity. I actually find the longevity on Noir de Noir brilliant, and it has a really big scent bubble on me, at least anyway. When I wear this one, I do get compliments, and bear in mind, I'm not an oversprayer. So to get a compliment on a fragrance when you don't do a massive amount of sprays is quite a big thing. And yes, in terms of the price point, Tom Ford is expensive, but you can pick this one up at Niche Gallery. I'm going to link them down below. They have incredible deals. I believe this one is 30% off at the moment. When you sign up, you can get 20% off automatically. And I also have an additional 10% off code with Hayley10. Feel free to use it if you wish, but of course, no pressure. They have some incredible deals on niche brands. So I just wanted to highlight that because they do stock Tom Ford and other incredible big niche brands. The next brand is Nuit Nomade, and I'm sure if you watch my channel, you would have heard me talking about this brand quite a lot. I feel like they have such incredible quality for the price point, and the fragrances are pretty unique too. Most of them are actually incredibly unique. So if you watch my channel regularly, before I actually showcase this fragrance, pause the video and go and write the fragrance you think I'm going to pick as my top one from the brand. So the fragrance that I've picked from the brand is none other than Jardins de Misfah. I absolutely adore Jardins de Misfah. I've made a pretty substantial dent, which doesn't really happen in my collection, and it is just one of my favorite Middle Eastern rose fragrances. It has a big dose of sweet sticky dates. You've got an extremely jammy rose in here. It's quite spicy, so there's lots of saffron and nutmeg. I get a little bit of an aromatic kick from the cardamom up top, and then it does have an almond note in here too, which kind of gives this a little bit of a creamy nuttiness. Yeah, I absolutely love this one. I get so many compliments when I wear this one too. Brilliant longevity, brilliant sillage. Highly, highly recommend. You can get so many different size formats of this, anything from a 2 ml sample all the way through to 10 ml, 25 ml, 50 ml and 100 ml. So yeah, Jardins de Misfah is my top pick from the brand, but I must say I do have some close second and third fragrances, which I won't touch on now, but I do have a brand overview on my YouTube channel if you are interested. The next brand is Ex Nihilo, and this is another brand that I really adore and I really resonate with. And again, I feel like a lot of you will be able to guess which fragrance I'm going to pick from the house. So without further ado, the fragrance that I am picking from Ex Nihilo is Fleur Narcotique. Now, I could have picked so many different fragrances for my top spot, but I am picking Fleur Narcotique because this is the one that resonates with me the most and the one that is the most special to me in my collection. If you don't watch my channel, you might not know this, but this is the fragrance that I wore for my wedding day, which was such a big decision for me. And I decided to go with Fleur Narcotique because it felt the most me. It's very floral. I think it's very feminine. I had a garden wedding, so I felt like it fitted the vibes really well too. It's sweet, but not too sweet. I feel like it's very classy and it's just a bouquet of peonies to me. That is what I get from this. It's a little bit musky too. Now, I have gone through a 50 ml bottle of this too. This is a newer 100 ml bottle. Some people don't get great longevity with this. I will have to mention that, but I actually don't struggle with longevity or sillage myself. So yeah, definitely do test this one out. But yeah, Fleur Narcotique would be my top choice from Ex Nihilo. The next brand that I'm going to be picking from is Initio. And this is also a brand I really, really love. But the fragrance I have picked for the top spot is none other than Musk Therapy. I hope I am not being too predictable with this list, but these are truly my favorite fragrances from each brand. Musk Therapy is the closest thing I have to a signature scent. It's definitely the one that I wear the most in my collection. It's clean, fresh, musky, of course, Musk Therapy, but it has a little bit of a juicy blackcurrant note in here that stops it being just too linear as a musky fragrance. Now, this isn't super unique and super complex, but what it is the perfect signature scent for those of you that love clean and musky fragrances like myself. I just think this one's truly special and it's really hard to put my finger on why. The first time I tried this in store, it didn't blow me away, but the second time I tried it, I made sure I put it on my skin and I fell in love. So yeah, Musk Therapy is my top choice from Initio. The next brand is Xerjoff, and I found this one a little bit more tough to pick my top fragrance, but when I sat down and really thought about it, I was like, this one is actually quite obvious, Hayley. And I feel like some people will assume I'm going to pick a different fragrance from Xerjoff, and some people will guess this one correctly, because there are two Xerjoff fragrances that I am ride or die for. But the fragrance that I picked for this list is Starlight. Absolutely love Starlight with my whole heart. This is a gorgeous cardamom, sweet, spicy fragrance that smells a little bit like baklava to me. Every time I wear this one, I'm absolutely intoxicated with the scent, and I just had to pick this one for my top spot. My second choice would have been Bouquet Idylle, another fragrance that I love, and it feels extremely me when I wear it, maybe even more me than Starlight, but I have to say I just love Starlight's composition so much that it had to win for me. It has the most beautiful projection. It's a lot of cardamom, but you also get a lot of sweetness coming through too. I would highly recommend this one if you want something that slightly resembles baklava. This is not a gourmand fragrance. I would say this is more of a spicy, sweet fragrance. And there are some citruses up top too. But yeah, Starlight is absolutely gorgeous and is my top pick from Xerjoff. The next brand is Stephane Humbert Lucas. And again, this one was very, very difficult to pick. There are two fragrances that I would say I am ride or die with that are absolute masterpieces to my nose, but I've gone with the one that I just can't stop thinking about and the one that intoxicates me the most, and that is Sol de Jeda Mango Kiss. I absolutely love this fragrance. It is probably my favorite mango fragrance in my collection. This is not a safe blind buy. I'm gonna just caveat that. It's a very complex mango fragrance with some interesting nuances. There's a chamomile note in here, which could be a little bit challenging to some people. And overall, the composition has that Stephane Humbert Lucas flair that you get within a lot of the collection. But in terms of a creamy mango scent, I love God of Fire too from the brand, but I would say this is more of a creamy, complex mango. And this is the one I'm going to be picking as my top recommendation. My second choice would have been Venom Incarnate, which again, feels more me when I wear it, similar to Bouquet Adil from Xerjoff. But when I think about the fragrance that I really, really love the scent profile of, it has to be Mango Kiss. The next brand is Parfums de Mali, and I found this one very, very difficult. Now, I decided to pick from the feminine collection, and again, I was slightly torn on this one. But the fragrance I have decided to pick in my top spot is Oriana. Now, I think a lot of you would assume I would pick Delina, and I was very, very close to picking Delina. It's a special fragrance to me. I wore it the day I got engaged. I've got beautiful scent memories attached to it. But if I was to think about getting rid of all of the fragrances in my collection and just picking one from each brand right now, it would be Oriana. It's an extremely feminine fragrance that smells like marshmallow, chantilly cream. There's lots of vanilla in here. It's got raspberry, and it smells a little bit like a raspberry marshmallow to me, dusted with powdered sugar, and it has a big cloud of vanilla. Just super, super addictive. I love wearing it. So I decided to pick Oriana as my top pick from Parfums de Mali. Apologies, I'm not going into lots of detail on each fragrance. I have reviewed all of these on my channel in detail, but this is more of a list of my top picks from each brand. So the next brand that I'm going to be picking from is going to be Guerlain. And this, again, was extremely difficult for me, but at the same time, very easy when I thought about it. And the fragrance that I have picked from Guerlain is Spirituese Double Vanille. I could have picked Angelique Noir quite easily, but this is the one I definitely reach for the most, and I just could not live without this. I didn't buy this for the longest time because of the price point, and it's not necessarily the most pow in your face vanilla fragrance, but equally that is what I love about it so much. This is what I would call a more sophisticated vanilla fragrance. It smells like luxurious vanilla bean ice cream that's not overly sweet. It has a beautiful sillage. It's about a medium sillage. It's not going to fill a room, and the longevity is about medium too. But at the same time, I just feel like this is so special, and Guerlain do vanillas in such a spectacular way, in my opinion. So I had to have Spirituese Double Vanille in my number one spot from the brand. The next brand is Fragrance Du Bois, and I was picking between two of my favorites, but I've gone with the one I feel like is the most versatile, and it is none other than Minuit et Demi. I feel like this fragrance is one of the most gorgeous, soft, cozy, spicy gourmands that's not overly sweet. It's balanced perfectly. And I wouldn't even say it's a typical gourmand in any ways. This is an edible, I'm going to eat it type of vibe, but it's just perfect. It gives me all of the vibes of wearing a cozy sweater. Maybe I'm sat on a sofa, drinking a hot drink of some sort and watching Netflix. It's just the most comforting scent and it catches so beautifully in the air, especially in the cooler weather. Now I was deciding between Minuit et Demi and Oujon Intense, but I do feel like this fragrance is more versatile. It's got all of my favorite notes in here. It has this beautiful coffee note that's quite subtle, but it's been done so perfectly. And it even has a slightly spicy pimento note in here. It's a little bit kind of boozy. It's got cardamom in here too. It's a little bit woody. I just feel like this is such a fantastic creation. And I can't wait to reach for it this fall and winter because I haven't been reaching for it in the spring and summer. And now is the season where I will be rocking this one. So my top choice from Fragrance du Bois is Minuit et Demi. And the last brand that I'm going to be touching on is Maison Francis Kurkdijan. And this brand has so many standout fragrances and I could have gone so many different ways with my choice, but the fragrance that I've picked in my personal top spot is Grand Soir. Grand Soir is one of the most sophisticated and beautiful amber fragrances in my entire collection. Completely unisex, and I feel like this one smells amazing on everyone. It's a slightly resinous amber. It's also a little bit vanillic and a tad bit spicy. Extremely classy and sophisticated, as I've already mentioned, and a staple in the fall and winter time. Now, Maison Francis Kurkdijan has some standout fragrances. I could have picked Baccarat Rouge, I could have picked Oud Satin Mood, even though that's not one of my favorites. I could have even picked Gentle Fluidity Gold just because I love it so much. But I feel like Grand Soir is one of those fragrances that so many people love. I wouldn't say it gets hyped up, but a lot of people talk about it. And this one was sold out for the longest time. I think it was last year going into this year. So my top choice from Maison Francis Kurkdijan is Grand Soir. So I hope you enjoyed this list. I'm going to continue doing these videos for all of the brands within my collection. I could at least make 3, 4, maybe 5 parts to this video. Let me know if you enjoyed this concept. And also let me know if you would like me to go into more detail on each fragrance because this was more of a fast-paced video. But what I want to know is from the brands that I discussed today, what are your top choices? Are they the same as me or do they differ slightly? Please do let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much for joining me today. It's been a pleasure as always. I hope to see you in a future video to come. Thank you so much and goodbye.